El Dorado Jane Doe is the name given to an unidentified American woman and identity thief estimated to be between 18 and 30 years of age who was murdered on July 10, 1991 in El Dorado, Arkansas in room 121 of the now torn down Whitehall Motel. The Jane Doe used multiple names while alive, including Mercedes, which is how her friends knew her, Cheryl Ann Wick, which was the name on the identification card found on her, Kelly Lee Carr, Kelly Carr, Shannon Wiley, Cheryl Kaufman and Sharon Wiley, none of which were found to be her real name. She was known to have lived in various states prior to her death, including Texas and Louisiana, and was alleged to have worked as a prostitute. While alive, Mercedes had shared varying accounts of her past, suggesting that she had been arrested at one point, had one or two children, and had possibly been involved in a bank robbery on the East Coast. Her murderer was identified as her ex-boyfriend and alleged pimp James McAlphin, and he was quickly convicted, but her true identity remains unknown. Activities prior to death. Residence Mercedes's earliest verified location is Dallas, Texas, where she was arrested for prostitution. She also worked at a KFC there. After leaving Dallas, she traveled to Shreveport, Louisiana, before going to El Dorado in early 1991. She also worked as a topless dancer in Little Rock, Arkansas, prior to her death and was found to have lived with a family in Irving, Texas. Arrest record December 31, 1990, arrested as Cheryl Ann Wick for prostitution at La Casita Motel in Dallas, Texas January 26, 1991, arrested in Dallas February 8, 1991, arrested as Cheryl Ann Wick for public lewdness at the Carousel Motel in Garland, Texas May 1991, arrested as Cheryl Ann Wick for writing bad checks in El Dorado, Arkansas. James McAlphin. Mercedes met James McAlphin while in Dallas. They began a relationship sometime after which Mercedes would often find herself in the emergency room to treat injuries suffered at the hands of McAlphin. Before McAlphin, Mercedes had been involved with men known as Tyrone and J.D. In June 1991, Mercedes finally left McAlphin and moved in with a friend named Andrea Cooksey. McAlphin continued to reach out to Mercedes, threatening her after the move out. On July 10, he managed to get Mercedes to come over to his room at the Whitehall Motel with an offer of money. A neighbor, Roy Charles Meenan, witnessed part of the interaction between Mercedes and McAlphin that night when he stopped by to ask for the return of some cassette tapes he had lent out. Mercedes had indicated to Meenan that he should talk to McAlphin and attempted to leave, going out into the parking lot before McAlphin stopped her and hit her. Crying, "Get back in the room, bitch," he dragged her back into the room as Meenan left. From next door, Meenan heard the two arguing back and forth before a gunshot ended the dispute. Witnesses then saw McAlphin flee, getting into his vehicle and speeding off. Investigation. McAlphin was soon arrested and charged with first-degree murder and second-degree battery. He denied killing Mercedes, claiming she had shot herself committing suicide and that he had only hit her. The police dismissed his claim. McAlphin further refused to identify the decedent unless the police would do something for him, only saying he had met her mother and sister when they visited from Florida. With McAlphin not being cooperative, the police looked to Mercedes' possessions to glean her identity. There they found a social security card and an identification card with her photo that identified her as Cheryl Ann Wick. The police traced Wick to Minneapolis, Minnesota, and contacted her family to inform them of their loss. The Wick family responded by putting the police in touch with the real Cheryl Ann Wick, who was still alive and claimed her identity had been stolen. Wick theorized her social security and identification information had been stolen while she was working as a dancer for a Minneapolis company called Party Time and denied ever having known Mercedes. The police were left dumbfounded with no clue as to the true identity of Mercedes. Accounts of her past from Mercedes. Mercedes had told differing stories about her past, making it hard to separate fact from fiction. She told her friend Andrea Cooksey that she used to be a stripper, was from out of town and had two kids raised by her mother with whom she didn't get along. To others, she had said she was in the witness protection program and that her father was in the mafia. Some people had heard that she was wanted for bank robberies on the East Coast. Police investigating her identity could not discover any bank robberies she could be tied to nor any connection to a witness protection program or the mafia. Another story Mercedes told was about being with an African-American male at truck stops where she had been tasked with luring truck drivers to rob them. She claimed that one of these interactions had ended with the death of the truck driver. This led police to suspect that Mercedes had been involved in the November 12, 1988 unsolved murder of truck driver Dwayne McCorkindale. A white female had been seen with a white male and a black male near the crime scene in a brown Ford Pinto. No definitive ties have been established, however. To a volunteer at the Salvation Army in El Dorado, Mercedes had shared a story about living on 1100 Cadiz Street in Dallas, which was the location of a homeless shelter. She said that a daughter had been taken from her while there and that she had been unable to get the child back because she was using another name. This information could not be verified because records from the shelter for this period had been destroyed by the time this story was being investigated. Account of her past from McAlphin. McAlphin has recently claimed to know the true identity of Mercedes and offered to reveal it in exchange for $4,000. To bolster his claim, he has shared select information he claims to be of her past. McAlphin has claimed that Mercedes had been on the streets since she was 16, when an African-American man she fell in love with forced her into prostitution in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. According to McAlphin, by the time she was an adult, she came to do it willingly. He further shared that Mercedes had avoided being trafficked to Mexico by developing a relationship with a pimp named Jeffrey, J.J. Davis of Dallas before running away with another pimp named Tyrone. Police have dismissed McAlphin as unreliable. 2019 developments. A second cousin of the victim living in Alabama was identified by a genealogist using genetic genealogy after uploading the unidentified woman's autosomal DNA to the GEDmatch database. The cousin did not recognize the victim but stated she resembled members of the family. See also list of unsolved deaths. Suzanne Savakis, Lori Erica Ruff, Joseph Newton Chandler III. References. External links. El Dorado Jane Doe at Namus. El Dorado Jane Doe at Find a Grave.